good Thursday morning to you, Show Nation. Let's jump right into Wednesday's baseball action. Starting in the AL West, the Friars finished off a two-game sweep as they defeated the A's in Oakland 5-0. Andy Pajes had an outstanding day, driving in 5 on 3 hits, leading the Astros to victory against the...
Yeah, this is a big game, so we all over now.
John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look-in. You're right on time. Rob Bain still on the mound to start this ninth inning. We'll see if he can wrap this one up and complete the shutout. Next offering is in for a strike. And he pumps it a strike.
Well, just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
On the ground to the left.
That ball's down line.
Foul.
Scouts.
And misses, struck him out.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Guys become defensive, and all of a sudden, for the hitter, that plate starts to get really wide.
That ball's through the hole for a base hit.
Pressure, you end up committing to a pitch as a batter before you recognize what it is, and that's what leads to the strikeout.
Here's O'Neill Cruz. Back up the... Oh, that got him! No chance for a play, and let's hope the righty's not hurt on the mound. So one out with two aboard, and now the right fielder, Andy Pajes.
His fans, they are ready to cheer about something.
That one's in there. That's strike one.
Hitter's got some good opposite field power. What I like about...
Goes to second.
Who's there? And the bases are juiced.
One down. And now the center fielder, James Outman. And time is called for a mound visit now. Big moment in this game, so they'll talk it over. Manager out of the dugout now, and he will make a move. On to pitch now for Oakland, Benito Mosquera.
I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at-bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
That's that corner. That's strike one. This one popped up. And it drops in. The throw in.
And get out of the play.
Of the inning on the force play.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Lee in the box lays off for ball one. And now 2-0.
Pressure's on right here. 2-0 count, base is loaded.
That ball's down line, foul.
Count and then a walk in or on. He's got to challenge the hitter right here.
On the ground.
It's gonna be tough play. Matano can't make the play.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet. Knowing that you can come through with a good swing. And there he doesn't try to do too much.
Ooh, yeah, I think he was out.
So two down. At the plate is the Astros catcher, Harry Ford. First pitch doesn't find the zone. And that's through there for a strike.
The zone.
And that one hit to first. He dives, but he can't make the throw to first, and he beats it. Everyone's safe.
Comes through with the RBI. Now that sets up a huge at bat in this ballgame.
Next to hit, warming Bernabeu. And there's a foul ball. Winning run stands at second. Swings and misses. And the count is 0-2.
Well, they're applying pressure. Quality at bats, quality swings right now. And see this offense.
How's it not a swing?
To the next, showing a lot of fight right now. They're making it difficult for the back end of this bullpen to close out this game.
The 1-2.
Got him!
The tying and go ahead runs are left aboard as this one is over.
After four wins in a row, you start to think a little bit that you're on a roll. That's the momentum that just takes on a life of its own. Guys start hitting up and down the lineup. Never know who's going to come up with the big hit, who's going to come out of the bullpen and get the big outs. But it's a good feeling, and you want to extend it.
A 3-2 final score.
Operating through eight innings, gave up two earned. But it's enough to get the win.
John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look-in. You're right on time. Andrew Vaughn will bring the middle of the order to the plate here in the ninth. Down just a run. Going around.
Well, and a bat can be a little bit of a dance. Strike one here, but a few more pitches. We'll see how it turns out.
Swing.
And a miss. Strike two.
Not a swing you want to watch again.
And he got him.
And the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
Isn't Phillips got with the cutter?
Always a big one for the closer. I mean, you get that punch out, you get settled in, you feel like you're in command out there on the mound from the jump, and kind of prevents any doubt from creeping into your mind or the guys that are playing behind you that, you know, you're gonna wrap this thing up.
That ball's far away. If we're gonna fall down 2-1 in the series.
Got him
looking.
This is definitely what a team likes to see out of their closer. Come in and just destroy all hope. First two batters, two strikeouts.
A batting Marcelo Meyer.
And now Marcelo Meyer. That misses the zone. Ball one. And there's a ball. Next offering is fouled back. Bounce to the right.
Bounce to the right. That's a tough play. And he got him.
And the Astros claim the win here behind some great pitching and defense.
Sandy Alcantara. Gets the job done.
Inside the show.
What? Why is Tasso Trimmel on right field? Really have no one for a second.
Oh. it's the right fielder, Frank Mosquera.
Not bad, Frank Mosquera. Is he leading off? Deals.
That Whoa, misses the zone, and we're underway here on Mother's Day.
That ball swung on hit near the center.
Buxton sizing it up.
Buxton is there.
Calls it in for the out. There's the shortstop at the plate. Marcelo Meyer struggling a little bit in the series. He's 2-for-12. In there, and it's 0-1. Singy Reed Detmers, 10th overall pick in the 2020 draft. You're talking about a guy who was a really good player at Louisville, and in his rookie year, he offered a no-hitter. Swings through that one for strike two.
Yeah, and in that rookie year with the nasty curveball, struck out 122 in 129 innings pitch. That's almost a strikeout per inning.
Got him looking.
An Illinois kid, but he grew up a Cardinals fan. When he was 11, the Cardinals won the 2011 World Series, and that's when he became a diehard Redbirds fan. Now the batter now, Chris Castilla. And it's fouled away. Kicks and deals. Strike two.
Everyone can have a little chuckle there. He's had such a great season. Rarely ever do you see that kind of swing.
That misses the zone. Now 1-2.
Rarely will you see a pitcher just waste a pitch like that. The batter wasn't even tempted to swing. Every pitch needs to have a purpose so that it can set up a following pitch to help you get that out.
The wide, the kick, and the 1-2. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
You don't know what we're
like. Here's the left fielder, Freddie Jeffries. The pitch. That one's in there, and it's 0-1.
That ball's getting down in there.
Off to a good start with a leadoff dive.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
And there's one away. Here's O'Neill Cruz. And a foul ball.
This guy absolutely flies. The defense wants to turn two, but they've got to get a ball they can do it.
Takes it in for the out.
Nothing you can do about those as a hitter. Even though you know that, they still drive you absolutely crazy.
Byron Buxton stands in here. Tried to hold back his swing there, but went around. And it's even up. And a foul ball. Here's a 1-2.
Got
him swinging. So the Astros lead one. Back here at the ball. Bottom half of inning number two. Now it's the veteran outfielder, Andy Pajes. And the first pitch misses for ball one. That's through there for a strike.
I got a ball, one strike.
Up the middle, lays out, he's got it.
To first is in time.
Great play to keep the leadoff man off base.
Great read off the bat by the second baseman. He took it perfect angle to get to this ball, knowing that he was going to have to dive to cut it off. Gets up and completes the play from the outfield grass. What a great job of picking up his pitcher.
And here is Harry Ford. Next pitch is popped up. Puts the squeeze on it, two away now.
This lineup's going to have to find a way to make him work a little harder out there on the mound. I mean, he is just mowing them down. He's settling in. You got to make him uncomfortable. Maybe step out of the box, call timeout, do whatever it takes.
Here's a 1-1. And a swing and a miss.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
Ripped on a line to center. And makes the Davis play, makes the and that's catch. Out number three. And welcome back. Welcome back. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for the Astros, warming Bernabéu. That misses off the outside edge. Norman goes 6 feet, 3 inches, 205 pounds, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. Late swing, fouled off.
Yeah, we have a really weird team.
To the right side, and it goes just foul. Here's the 1-2. Fouled off the plate. They'll do it again. 1-2 here. Fouls it back with two strikes. On the ground, right side. The flip to the pitch.
You got him.
One up, one down.
Good arm side run and sink on that pitch right there. Got inside on him and got him to bounce into that out.
This is Willy Castro. Didn't play in last night's game. A little breather for him. In the
air,
center
near the center.
Field, Davis drifts towards it, makes the catch for the out. Now the left fielder, Freddie Jeffries. And that one is lifted in the air. Green.
The red at Green makes the catch. Three up, three down.
Bottom of the fourth, and now the shortstop, Joseph Ortiz. There's the strike.
Well, these Astros, to put it bluntly, need to put together more competitive at-bats, and I don't think they've lived up to their own
This one's into the outfield. Could be extra bases. And that rolls into the corner. Throws to second, into second base. The tying run is on with a leadoff double.
Really good swing right there. He got a pitch that he knew he could handle. Allowed himself to stay back just a tad bit longer, and he hit the ball on the screws.
Green makes the grab, one away.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity, but a competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
Buxton up to bat next, lays off for a ball. And that is cut on and missed. And it's one and one. And another ball.
That two-seam fastball is usually coupled with a slider away, and when a hitter's conscious of the pitch in, it's hard for him to cover middle away, and that's where a pitcher can really finish off that bat.
Got him looking.
Got him. Two gone now.
Well, even if you don't feel great about it, you've got to swing
hand the bat on the outside corner.
In this situation, you've got the tying run out there in scoring position. Just put the ball in play. Maybe something good will happen.
What?
It just didn't look like he understood the situation.
Two outs and one in scoring position. So now one and two. On the ground, right side.
Vaughn
makes
the play.
First out, number three. Back here in Houston. Back here at Minute Maid Park, we head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's a speed threat, Harry Ford. That one is absolutely belted
off the wall.
And it's a one-hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. Safe at second with nobody out, and he represents the tying run.
Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock. Now a pretty big at-bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
That one pushed foul.
Look out. That ball was smoked. Man, I am so relieved that they have this netting down the lines just ensures safety for the fans. Last thing as a player, you want to look up and see a fan get hit.
Little trouble with this one behind the plate, and the runner holds. Next offering is fouled back.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit,
ball's in the air,
run, so you really have to execute on the mound. Well, he's desperately looking for that swing and miss. He's going to have to just change speeds a little bit, try to move it around, create just a little bit of illusion at the end.
Meyer to first, and that's the first out in the bottom of the fifth.
And there's one away.
And next to hit for Houston, warming Bernabéu. In there for strike one. forward. The runner at second with one away. Line drive. He's got it. There's two away.
Right at Vaughn.
So up next, Willie Castro. Ball one, no strikes. There's a strike. Next offering misses. 2-1. This one lifted in the air. Left field. Green
is there.
And that is that.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the gym.
Bottom of the sixth inning. Now the left fielder, Freddie Jeffries. Swing and a miss. 1-1.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
Got him.
It misses. It's a strikeout.
Well, you see him trying to pull that inside pitch right there, and that's not the kind of approach that you want to have. Even if you do get to it, it's going to be very difficult to keep it fair. You're just going to make it a long strike at best. You have to be able to stay within the baseball on the inside of that path to it, and that way, if you're a little quick, the ball gets hit hard somewhere, and it's not foul.
Swing and a miss struck him out.
You got Joe.
Chris, third time through the order, and a couple of quick outs for the starter.
Yeah, he's been very frugal today, economical with the pitch count.
Cruz stands in now and watches strike one. Outside corner for a strike.
I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime, you would see a lot of guys out in front, right-handers pulling that.
Well, play's first made there, and that retires.
Inning over.
New inning getting. And welcome back. Set for the last half of the seventh. Here's Byron Buxton. Norman, back to work.
Well, it's been a very impressive outing so far. His command has been a big part of it. Even when he misses outside the strike zone, which is exactly what a pitcher wants. Well, no base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard.
Got him.
Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
Late swing, fouled off. Swung out, belted. Deep.
And Pages goes yard.
Change speeds, even try to trick the hitter at times. But when you give up a home run right there, manager doesn't have a lot of patience because the velocity's not there to overcome and get the swing and miss.
And now the count is even. And he takes a strike.
A 1-2 count, all he's seen is fastballs. You've got to expect something off speed. Stay back.
A 1-2. On the ground, right side, and he takes it himself for the out.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run.
Your attention, please. Now, passing for the athlete, number 81, Jerry. Now, passing for the athlete.
Back here in Houston, out of the bottom of the eighth, here's the third baseman, warming Bernabeu. Right-handed reliever, way outside, and the count is 1-2. Way inside, gets out of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Righty to the plate. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch. Up and in. Want to try and tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
Got him.
By him for the K.
Well, that was a really good job setting him up right there. Pitcher and catcher working together to finish him off with the fastball. And even though the location probably wasn't what he wanted, the sequence is what got the job done. Clearly they with the swing after seeing the off-speed stuff on the pitch before.
Righty delivers. Swing and a miss. And he got him to chase. Good eye right there. The 2-2.
Yeah, looking at them, pump them.
And now it's filled up.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter.
Ball four.
He's got to be ready to swing it.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
He gets there to make the play. A nice running grab. And there are two down. Oh, the throw is over his head. So digging in, Joseph Ortiz. And there's the strike.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Two gone. The possible go-ahead run at first. Next pitch misses. And a count 1-2. Knocks that one.
That ball's up.
And we'll do it
again.
And
that ball's crushed down the line. If it stays fair, it's go.
Him swinging for the K. Chase the fastball up the ladder for strike three. We go to the ninth.
Three.
Back here in Houston, we head to the bottom of the ninth, and here is O'Neal Cruz. Bounce to the right side.
Hit.
Steps on first for the out.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Next offering is in for a strike.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Got him!
Two out. Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take.
That ball's down the line if it stays fair.
Other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
Pitch misses, and it's a ball to strike. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. Next offering is in for a strike. That's out to center field.
Hit in the air,
Davis
right at
it.
Davis will make the catch.
Grab and that'll end the inning.
And over.
We're in.
Thank God.
On to the bottom of the 10.
We're on second.
The pitch.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. When you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
The 1-1. And that's down and away. Activity in the bullpen for Houston. Will Vest getting ready to go. Lopez getting cranked up as well. The 3-1 in for a strike, full count. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum. Very quickly, they're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
And first offering is fouled off. Trying to get him to chase on the changeup that time. Nobody out. both the tying and winning runs on base.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge.
That ball's crushed foul.
Fouled off 2-2. Good eye right there.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Got him.
Three, got him swinging. And that is a big first out.
Well, that's a blue zone right there, or the cold zone on the hitting chart. Just doesn't have much success in that part of the strike zone. And a really good job of the pitcher executing. Try to go there as often as you can. The numbers are in your favor.
Good eye in that spot.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Fouled off. He was late. Big spot. Tying and winning runs aboard with one down. And misses, struck him out.
Now, Boog, it becomes pretty difficult as a teammate when a guy's struggling like this. You don't know if you want to go up and tell him to keep swinging at him, or if you want to give him his space, what exactly he needs. But right now, it's clearly a struggle for him, and you're just hoping that somehow, some way, it'll click and he can get out.
What? Come on, ump.
The 1-1. And strike two.
Man, I'm pretty impressed out there on the mound right now. I mean, these are tough spots where pitchers really got to bear it out. Those last two pitches were well executed.
And for the third, he got him.
Third, and they got it out to end it. And they strand the tying and go-ahead runs to earn the win.
Well, this is a big win on the road and going extras into 10. So hard to pull those out, but I think this team did a great job of keeping the crowd out of the ballgame late. When you can do that, it kind of calms everything down, keeps the adrenaline.
John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. We'd like to welcome those just tuning in on the show for a live look-in. You're right on time. The A's up to bat here in the bottom of the inning with a chance to walk it off. Signs of movement in the Giants bullpen. Gilberto Alessio, the left-handed reliever, appears to be getting loose. Alvarado getting loose as well. One away, and the game-winning run stands at second. So, a foul ball
that
makes
ball's crushed foul.
His eyes got big. He saw that changeup way out in front. Better to pull it than to get jammed on something off speed like that.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Chased the fastball up the ladder for strike three.
Full four. Take the base.
Miguel Vargas up next for the A's. He's already homered in this game. Swings through that.
For a guy that's been swinging the bat well all game long, that was a pretty ugly swing right there. I'm sure he'll tighten it up on this next pitch.
Next one misses, and next offering is fouled back.
Okay, I can't get to that. Okay. It looks like we're finding our stride.
Good evening. morning to those joining us for this live look in on the show. I'm John Ciambi alongside Chris Singleton. You're just in time. Alexis Medrano will bring the middle of the order to the plate here in the ninth. Down just a run.
Well, I say it's the best pitch in baseball. Strike one. You get ahead on a good hitter as well. Gives a little bit more confidence to move to the at bat.
In there for a strike at the bottom of the zone.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out.
That ball's in the air. Center field. That ball way out. Get down.
In. Run comes in from second.
And we're tied.
Game 4-4.
Huge moment for him and his team, Boo. You know, some guys just grip it a bit too tight in a big spot like this. Having a chance to tie it up in the bottom of the ninth. But he didn't let the moment get to him. Comes up with the RBI knock, and now he's giving his teammates a chance to walk this thing off with the win if they can push across another run.
New arm out of the bullpen, your Donnie Ventura.
Well, he's a big-time strikeout guy out there. This season, averaging more than one per inning.
0-1 now. Just missed.
One ball, one strike.
Swing and a miss. Nice changeup.
For a guy that's been swinging the bat well all game long, that was a pretty ugly swing right there. I'm sure he'll tighten it up on this next pitch.
That ball's down line. Foul.
Tied at four. Pitch misses. Now 2-2.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
And he got him.
Struck him out. Pulled the string.
Changeup is so damn slow.
All set for the start of the inning. So in now for the Angels, George Valera. Here comes a pitch.
Well, it's kind of deflating. You blow that lead in the bottom of the ninth. So here's a new opportunity. Hit the reset button. Try to get some more runs and then close it out in the bottom half of this one.
Kicks and fires. Misses off the play, and that's ball two. A little bit low. Edge of the zone for a strike. 3-2 now. Swing and pop up in foul ground. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One away. Now it's the right fielder, Joey Weimer. And time is called for a mound visit now. Big moment in this game, so they'll talk it over. Close, but called a ball. And it's 1-0.
Home plate umpires trying to tighten things up a little bit.
Leroy Byers comes on now.
And that one fouled away.
And a pitch. This one
popped up foul territory.
Base side. Vaughn snags it for the second out.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Ohapi in the box now. Takes strike one. That one finds the zone. No balls, two strikes. Two down. Go ahead, run in scoring position. Next offering is down low.
0-2 count. You got the opportunity to expand the zone. Could get the
got him looking
right through there. Got him. And good work there as he gets back.
In a two-run shot. Marcelo Meyer goes yard. Okay, so we currently sit 2.5 games back. Anyway, that'll do it for this episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Have a good one, and I'm out. Bye.